What's going on, guys? Welcome to the channel. Consider subscribing to watch me play some retro and new games. Comment below any game suggestions and enjoy the video. What's going on, guys? Welcome back to the channel. We're here with another NBA 2K23 MyTeam playthrough, playing domination up against the Thunder today. Need to win by 15 points. Only real objective I am aiming to complete in this game is 25 points with a destroyer player who I'm going to be using Kawhi Leonard for that, so I'm going to be playing through him a lot. Outside of that, just trying to use Evolution, Ja Morant, Durin, and Agbaji just to get their upgraded cards. Apart from that, it's all smooth sailing, so hopefully we get an easy win against a pretty poor
it's
team.
It's time for the NBA, live on 2K Sports. Kevin Harlan here with Greg Anthony and a pair of Hall of Famers with us, Doris Burke and David Aldridge. So here's Oklahoma City's starting group. We'll see Dort and Beasley playing it forward. Josh Giddey is out there with Gilgeous Alexander, and it's Favors in at the pivot spot, manning the middle. We've got Durin. Kawhi Leonard is out there with Morant. And it's Mathurin in at the small forward.
Wise beyond his years, Giddey has a great feel for the game and terrific court vision.
Well, the other thing you love, Greg, is the size he gives you out of the backcourt. Obviously, he needs to improve his consistency from range, but he's got all the tools you must have if you're going to be an all-star in the NBA. Well, very hard to deal with Kawhi Leonard in the pick and roll. His mobility allows him to be an effective roller.
And Gilgeous Alexander's got the ball here for Oklahoma City. Here's Beasley. He's covered by Leonard. Outside, Dort. Off to a good start as he hits his first shot attempt.
Boy, you've got to have a tight handle to make that kind of move. Lou Dort, show off.
And that was the mobile one drive. Well worth a second look.
It's all about the ability to get 2 feet in the paint, whether it's creating for a teammate or for yourself. Good way to start this game. You want to get him rolling as early as possible.
He's a guy who, if he gets hot, he can carry your offense for long stretches.
Now here's Favors. Ball's knocked loose, and it's out of bounds. Oklahoma City able to retain possession here. And so here is Oklahoma City. Here's Dort. And it's Mathurin with the rebound.
Boy, against so little defensive pressure, you have to convert that.
And foul on the shot, so he'll get a chance at the line. And of course, there's some pretty cool stories right there about Kawhi Leonard and what he has done in the community.
There really are, Kevin. I think about it. When he wins the Defensive Player of the Year award, that comes with a car. And instead of using it for his own personal use, he donated that to a children's welfare charity. This is the same guy who gave 1 million backpacks to kids in need in Los Angeles. Just a few of the things he does for his community.
Back to Gilgeous Alexander. Just 5 on the clock. Fires the three. Morant with some nice D. Here's Leonard. Good, and a nice assist from Morant. Leonard's got his third bucket of the night.
But Kawhi Leonard's strength through contact, one of the real problems you've got to deal with as a defender.
Outside, Dort. The pass to Beasley. From outside the arc. The Thunder keep it going. A new 14-second clock. Count that one.
Now, this is going to help Josh Giddey's game. Boy, the confidence will rise if he can make these catch-and-shoot opportunities.
Morant against Gilgeous Alexander. And it's Leonard with the jam.
Taking it to the rack with power.
Hammering down the two-hand slam. Pass to Giddey, back to Gilgeous Alexander. Kawhi Leonard comes up with the rebound. There's a minute 47 left in the first quarter of the game. And with the 15th pick in the 2011 draft, Kawhi Leonard wasn't highly touted coming out of high school or college.
Listen, even in the pros, recognition took a while. How about this? He won Finals MVP and Defensive Player of the Year before he ever made an All-Star team. Now, one of the 75 greatest.
And first timer of the game called for Oklahoma City.
And with their offense sputtering, coaches got to get them back on track.
And to me, they're just taking too many tough shots. And when they do get an easy one, the confidence just isn't there.
The offensive rebound, and it's blocked. And they'll get another chance. And they're able to recover. They get a hand on it.
And really just a great play to sacrifice his body and take the charge.
A sensational block that definitely deserves another look.
And an early swat like that can really set the tone. Now the shooters will be feeling his presence.
And it's Jaden Ivey with the foul. That is his first foul of the game.
First team foul.
And we're just over 3.5 minutes into the first quarter. They could use a big shot here to get this offense going.
Too many empty possessions. Right now they need a basket.
Passes it to Favors. Outside, Gilgeous Alexander. Five on the clock. Here's Baisley. Rebound by Williams. 56 seconds left to play in the first quarter. Leonard attacking. Shoots over towards. And stolen by Giddey. 8 feet away. Jump shot is good that time.
Well, the pull-up jump shot of Josh Giddey is going to be hard to guard, folks. 6'8" and really long.
Ivy kicks to Leonard. And it's Leonard with the jam.
And if you look at this first half, overall, they've just had the better shot selection.
And I think, obviously, we see the execution and the willingness to make the next pass so important.
Now, here's George. Takes it off the glass.
Well, Dort touched the paint, and he was immediately thinking score.
Here's Leonard. Puts up a three, and it's in. Basket number 6 for him thus far. He has only missed 2 shots from the floor.
And he's really made the most of his opportunities today. I mean, he needs to keep working for those kinds of looks.
Williams with the block. And it's out of bounds. They say it was last touch by Williams. Here's Giddey. Pass to Gilgeous Alexander for 3. And the last shot before the buzzer is off. And that does it for the first quarter.
Oh, there's quarter time.
The Pistons.
That's pretty strong first quarter for Kawhi Leonard in particular. He's got all 7-8 of our points. So, don't think I'm going to have a problem getting the 25 with him, but he could be in for a big game if I keep pushing him. We'll see. But 9-point lead, pretty comfortable.
Guys, what's your take on the
Let's
home team
start,
so far?
Keep it going in the second
you
quarter.
You got to credit their defense. Communicating, rotating, making plays on the ball.
Yeah, I think they wanted to come out of the gate strong, and they have. They've taken the early lead here.
Taking a look at the Thunder, we'll see Dort and Baisley playing it forward. Gilgeous Alexander out there with Josh Giddey, and it's Favors in at the 5. 4 on the clock. Steps back and fires, and that one is off.
Well, they get it to the high percentage area, and then it all goes wrong from there.
And it goes down 2 points. Leonard's got 19 points.
This is a small forward who, because he's 230 pounds, can hold his own down in the low post. That is nicely done.
Giddey the pass to Gilgeous Alexander. Good on the shot.
This guy can do so much for you on the offensive end, and that is why his number gets called time and time again.
Leonard looking over the floor. His 3-pointers off the mark.
Not quite enough defense. That time around, just lucky he was off.
This team is credited Giddey's background for shaping him as a player.
You know, he grew up in a house dominated by basketball. Both his parents played professionally in Australia, and that goes a long way toward developing your basketball IQ.
Now, here's Gilgeous Alexander. Dort finds Gilgeous Alexander. Here's Baisley, Ori defending. Here's Dort. Score of the basket, his third after five shots.
Now, this guy's a team first guy, and if you're open and Baisley can put it on time and on target, he is more than willing.
And a great job to get that angle on a tremendous drive.
And a bucket like that one might be just what they need to cut into this lead.
This is his third trip to the free throw line in the game, and the first one drops.
At the line for your home.
Leonard hits them both.
Probably as close to a sure thing as you can have at the free throw line.
Outside, Dort. And contact on the shot, so he'll be shooting free throws here. Torres, in your opinion, how does Luke Dort stack up with the best undrafted players in the league?
Well, I think, Kevin, when you think undrafted, the first guys that come to mind are Fred VanVleet, who's now an NBA champion, Christian Wood, Seth Curry, who's proven to be such a capable shooter. Those three are clearly, to me, the best undrafted players that come immediately to mind. But Luke Dort, I'll tell you, has carved out one heck of a career. This guy is a lockdown defender, and he can now make open threes.
Leonard, he's checked in for Ori. We're now about 2 minutes into the second quarter. To the middle, stolen away. Dort, wide open. And again, Oklahoma City, no good. Here's Leonard. During the pass to Leonard. Drops it in from 11 feet. Leonard's got 25 points in the game.
Well, Kawhi understands that the team relies on him for consistent productivity.
Time called here. The Thunder decide to talk it over. We have to like what we're seeing so far from Kawhi Leonard.
And he has absolutely worn them out in the paint. They need to come up with a plan to limit his touches in the interior.
And favors kicks to Dort. On the wing, Giddey. Over to the left wing. Baisley. Good on the three-point shot. Baisley's got himself going with the triple, his first basket of the game.
Boy, the stroke on Baisley's shot keeps getting better. He's turning himself into a real threat.
And finished off by Leonard.
Yet another bucket in close. That's how he's earning his points today.
2 minutes remaining in the first half.
Now, Gilgeous Alexander. There's the pass to Giddey. To the left wing. Shot clock at five. And Favors kicks to Giddey. With the shot. Rebound, Kawhi Leonard.
The shot's there for him, and he's got to take it. I don't care if he doesn't convert. That's a shot he has to continue to take.
Count it. Leonard's got 12 points now in the quarter.
Kawhi Leonard, if you allow him to get to his spots, it's an easy score. In the painted area, that's easy money.
Pass to Giddey. Gilgeous Alexander surveying the D. Kicks it to Favors. Back to Gilgeous Alexander. And good that time. Gilgeous Alexander's got his second bucket.
Because of his length, Shea Gilgeous Alexander has no issues operating near the cup.
And it's Leonard missing. Oklahoma City trails by 12. Pass to Favors. 40 seconds left in the first half. In the hoop for his third make from the field. He's 3-for-4 thus far in the contest.
That's outstanding footwork by Josh Giddey. Finish in the painted area. I can do that too.
And I've been impressed with the unselfishness, but also getting guys the ball where they can do something with it.
And he has shown a terrific feel for how the defense is playing him and then taking advantage of that.
And Favors kicks to Giddey. 8-second difference between the shot clock and the game clock. And oh boy, a lot of contact there, but he gets the call and will shoot two. It goes on Jaden Ivey.
So there's that combination of size and quickness when we're talking about Josh Giddey. Hard to defend, makes the defender commit right there.
He's off on the second. Here's Obagi. They grab their own miss. Ori gets the bucket.
Nice possession. Ori getting the close look to go.
That's tipped. Here's Morant. And Morant throws it down.
That's a double whammy, guys.
That's right. A great defensive play. Then the impact.
Oh, there's halftime. Up to a 16-point lead now. Oh, they're just cruising along. Playing pretty poor defense, to be honest, but pounded it with Kawhi. Who's got 31 points.
And after a very lopsided first half.
Pretty sure 31 points for Kawhi. I think he needs 54-4 for some random challenge that I didn't even know was there until the start of this game. So I'm probably just going to try and force it with Kawhi and just get that challenge, but we'll see how it goes.
We'll see if things right, play out a little more evenly here in the second. Kawhi Leonard really has his fingerprints all over this one.
He's done a fantastic job of finding open space to operate within the first few quarters.
One of the things every player is after is efficiency at the offensive end. And boy, this young guy has done just that.
So with Jordan on the bench, this is Mike Budenholzer's lineup. Durant out there with Kawhi Leonard. Then it's Morant. And it's Obagi in at the shooting guard position. And Kawhi Leonard with the slam.
What a deft pass by Morant. He finds a wide open man as quickly as anybody in our league. In terms of entertainment factor, can any current player top Ja Morant? I mean, we've seen Ja with some vicious in-game throwback.
And the whistle blows. It's going to be on Ja Morant. That's his first foul. Giddey with it. He has six. Here's Dort. And he converts the layup. Dort's got eight. Hey, Greg, talking about the great Ja Morant. This guy is just flat out fun to watch.
Well, Ja's been known to go off for 50 on any given night, but he also looks for others, dropping some nasty dimes. Morant has an insane combination of athleticism and skill. This guy can do anything.
Time called here. The Thunder decide to talk it over.
Well, it's been an express lane to the rim. Coach can't be happy about that.
Well, poor rotations, poor communication. There's a lot to figure out right now.
Here's Gilgeous Alexander, and he uses the glass on the layup. And that's now 6 points for Shai Gilgeous Alexander. Mathurin passes to Leonard. Two free throws coming up, and they call the shooting foul.
You can see the kind of savvy Kawhi Leonard plays with. This guy makes the defense commit and gets himself to the foul line.
Leonard hits them both. Right around a minute and a half played here in the third quarter. Gilgeous Alexander passes to Dort. And what a play, just snatched out of the air. Credit the block. Dort against Leonard. That shot misses. And it's Oklahoma City the other way.
Home team foul.
Boys check in for Kawhi Leonard.
First personal foul. Team second. Into the lineup for your home team, Robert.
Here's Giddey. He has six. Outside, Gilgeous Alexander. For the three. Durin pulls it in. Durin's got his fifth rebound in this one. So Mike Budenholzer decides to take a timeout here. And Greg Anthony for Shai Gilgeous-Alexander, part of a growing trend in this NBA, giving his team length in the backcourt.
Yeah, 6'6 with a 6'11 wingspan. He can see over the top of the defense He helps you on the glass, and he can switch onto front court players defensively. That's what teams are looking for nowadays.
Leonard on the wing. Shoots over Dort, and that one goes long. Oklahoma City trails by 18. On the wing, Gilgeous Alexander. And he drops in the layup off the glass. Gilgeous Alexander's got 4 points in the quarter.
Well, great decision from Dort. If your teammate is open, get him the basketball. Nicely done.
And Gilgeous Alexander's got the ball here for the Thunder. Morant with the steal. And oh, here we go with Leonard. Nobody down. And Kawhi Leonard with the slam.
Well, speed, intelligence, touch. Kawhi Leonard has it all.
Here's Gilgeous Alexander. 8 points for him. Pass to Giddey. Back to Gilgeous Alexander. And there's the whistle. Illegal screen.
When a pick like that is questionable, it creates that much of an advantage for the offense. You have to blow the whistle.
I don't think there's any question. There are so many rules that favor the offense these days. You've got to be able to equal things out when an illegal screen is set.
And here's Leonard from three. Favors with the rebound. Oklahoma City trails by 18. And now a fast break for the Thunder.
That level of physicality and hops by Baisley. That's a big time statement.
Outside Leonard. Shoots over Dort. Durin the pass to Leonard. And he gets the whistle. Two free throws coming up. They get Derek Favors.
Yeah, good job to take him right at the game.
Pretty much automatic tonight at the line, 8 for 8.
He has come through in a big way at the foul line in this game.
Well, Kawhi Leonard has turned himself into an offensive force. He's a three-level scorer, but I think you have to admire the fact that this guy is as versatile as it gets on the defensive end. He could guard 1 through 5 if necessary.
Now a timeout called by Oklahoma City.
And he could tell his guys starting to wear down a little bit. Call time to just let them get their legs back under him.
Second half here. We're just over 3.5 minutes into it. Gilgeous Alexander kicks to Giddey. That's tipped, and he's able to get it back. 5 to shoot. Gilgeous Alexander. The rebound by Ivy. Gilgeous Alexander's gone 4 of 10 here, has 6 misses. Leonard against Dort. Leonard with the bucket. Leonard's got 43 points.
Unwilling to let up, even for a moment. That's his killer instinct, just fanning the flames.
One thing I enjoy is watching players who don't pay attention to the score. You lock in on the moment and play the right way.
And foul on the shot. He'll shoot 2 at the free throw line. And so he's picked up his final foul. He will sit for the rest of this game. What a contribution at the line so far, going 10 for 10. A free throw good from Kawhi Leonard. Both free throws good from Kawhi Leonard. Here's Gilgeous Alexander. 8 points for him. Some tough offensive sets. They want to turn it around.
Yeah, right now you just need a bucket to get some momentum.
Now the pass to Giddey. And again, no good by Oklahoma City.
Listen, if you're that wide open, you have to take the shot, even if it's not your favorite.
It's rebounded by Oklahoma City. The baseline J. Rebound by Williams. Williams has got his 4th rebound with that last one here tonight. Gilgeous Alexander with the steal. And at the end of the third quarter, a huge lead in this one.
Well, this 3-quarter time, 22 points.
The Detroit Pistons.
Kawhi Leonard. I'm forcing him way too much with him, but I've come too far not to get the 54 points. Got the 4 rebounds I needed. Got my direct opponent fouled out.
Now let's take a look at I'm all over him. Of the game presented
but
by State
very
Barn.
Fatigued. And
he sliced the D wide open.
I'm forcing it too much.
They had no chance to prevent that.
Hopefully
basket.
We get it done
well,
quickly this quarter and
right? You love
can just
the
muck around
play.
For the rest of the game. Let's do it.
And one quarter to go in a game that to this point has not been an evenly fought contest. So for Oklahoma City right now, we'll see Dort and Beasley playing it forward. Josh Giddey is out there with Gilgeous Alexander, and it's Favors in at the center, locking down the middle. And here is Gilgeous Alexander.
And you know, Shea Gilgeous Alexander's rise to NBA stardom was meteoric.
Well, for me, GA, the more responsibility this guy seems to be given, the better he gets. He's improved every year, and at this point in Shea's career, it looks like his ceiling could be very, very high. What a promising future for Shea Gilgeous Alexander. He's long, he's athletic, he can play the one and the two, and perhaps the most important thing is everyone raves about his character and his coachability.
Outside, Gilgeous Alexander. And here we go, Morant heading to the hoop. Pass to Duren, back to Morant. Gilgeous Alexander with the steal. Over in the corner, Dort. Off the mark there with the three-point shot.
And the way he was able to reach out towards that release had an impact.
Well, no question. He altered that shot. And most of the time, that's just as good as blocking it.
And that one's good, Leonard.
Yeah, they're rolling right now. That lead continues to grow.
And one of the things that's helped that is they're getting it done on both ends. Terrific focus on offense, and they're locked in defensively.
Knocked loose. Leonard with the steal. And here comes Leonard leading the fast break. And the foul called on Josh Giddey. That is his first foul of the game.
You know what? You've got to always be in control of your emotions.
Substitution for the home team.
About a minute and a half through the fourth quarter now.
Rob Ori.
Here's Mathurin. And nothing but hair on that one.
Well, certainly not the best defensive effort, but this guy can't make them pay for their laziness.
Now flying high and throwing it down with the one hand.
One of his favorite moves right there, guys. And there's the call on Lou Jordan. That's his first foul. Leonard, he's checked in for Barnes.
Team second.
Left with a wide open look. An absolute bomb from three-point range. West has got himself going there. His first points of the game on the deep ball. Passes it to Giddey. Dort against Leonard. Dort misses.
And his defense, so valuable. Not many can bother that shot at the rim.
Boy, you see the effort. You see the range. This guy prides himself in his ability to shut you down.
Giddey against Jordan. Unloads from 13. Giddey, no good.
And he rushed that one, no doubt about it. The D out of position, you could see the frustration on his face.
Boy, what is more fear-invoking than Kawhi off the bounce near the cup? Look out.
And here's Gilgeous Alexander. He'll bring it up for Oklahoma City. Beasley passes to Dort. Takes the three. And the rebound collected by Ori. Ori's got six rebounds in the game. They get the rebound. And Leonard gets it to go.
As Kawhi likes to say, board man gets paid.
They need a bucket in a big way here to regain some confidence.
Here's Beasley, Ori defending, and that'll be two free throws coming up. Officials on the call with the foul.
First personal foul. Team second. At the line.
He misses the free throw.
Boy, Darius Beasley is enticing, guys. You're talking about a lengthy, athletic big man with outstanding versatility.
And no good on the second free throw, so he goes 0-for-2 there. They have been really controlling this one.
You never want to be complacent on the floor. That's when you lose momentum.
Pass to Abaji from downtown. Offensive rebound for three. West. Good, and it's Jordan picking up the assist. West has got six in the quarter.
I mean, that's what I'd call the prototype. When you talk about catching and shooting, West squares those shoulders, elbow in perfect alignment. Money.
Outside, Dort. Back to Faber. Just five to shoot. Here's Giddey. The Thunder with another miss.
He is just not taking smart shots out there. A pattern he has fallen into tonight.
The pass to Abaji. Three-pointer. That shot missing. Now Oklahoma City takes it the other way.
Home team foul. Robert Orr. Second personal foul.
That free throw, no good.
Shooting for the away team.
And the second free throw, good.
Yeah, he cuts the deficit a little bit, but not as much as he could have. One miss can make a big difference.
Here's Abaji. Jordan dishes to Morant. The three. Thunder with the rebound. And the whistle blows. It's going to be on Ja Morant. So that will be his second foul of the game. We're in the bonus. We'll go to the line to shoot two.
What we know about Luke Dort is this guy is an excellent defender. He's got size, strength, versatility. You can basically throw him at the other team's best offensive weapon night after night.
Now here's Morant for three. Oh!
My goodness.
What a finish with the reverse dunk.
That is a product of pure effort, guys.
I agree, and that's nothing new coming from him, GA. He loves going to work on the rebounding, going to work on the boards.
What about the decisive finish? Great timing, tremendous force.
Robert Orr, third personal foul.
That's good from Gilgeous Alexander.
Shooting for the away.
Gilgeous Alexander hits them both. West outside. Can't get it to fall. So the home crowd happy here as they
well, the this game over 32-point win. Quality, huge game. Forcibly didn't weigh too much, but got what I needed from him. A lot of points. 886 MyTeam tokens. Happy with that. All three challenges, of course. Quiet Leonard. Still shot a pretty good percentage. 21 of 35, 12 of 12 free throws, 55 points, 5 rebounds, 1 assist, 1 steal. How my other guys go? Ja Morant, Abaji, Durant I'm happy with because I think I only needed one more block to upgrade him. The other two I didn't really do much with. But it is what it is. Until next time, guys. Catch you later. Thanks for watching, guys. Don't forget to check out my page down below. Hit like on this video. Comment what games you'd like to see me try out next. And don't forget to subscribe. Peace.